This demonstration will show you how you can use an iPhone or an iPod Touch to control an Arduino. The Arduino in this setup is in this little white box, and it's connected through its data port to this motor driver, and the motor driver is connected to the stepper motor. The Arduino is also connected to this iPod Touch through this cable. Now, the iOS devices have a data port on them, but we're not using the data port because Apple has a lot of control over that. They require you to go through special licensing in order to use that port for your external device. So instead, what I've done is I've connected the Arduino using the audio port of the iPod Touch. So the instructions to the Arduino go out on the headphone port and they come back to the iPod Touch over the microphone port. So I've already stored a small motion for the motor in the Arduino, and I can start that up just by hitting a couple buttons on the iPod Touch application. So you see the motor started turning. And what it's going to do, I'll run it again, is it's going to turn 2 revolutions and repeat that 3 times. 1, 2, 3 repetitions. Okay, so the first thing I can do is I can change the number of rotations it makes in each repetition. And I do that by typing some numbers here on the iPod Touch application and sending them to the Arduino. The Arduino will come back and confirm that it got the information, and then when I run the job again, it will make 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. All right, I can also change the number of repetitions. I can do that by setting a different value. And when I run it again, it will do it 5 times. 1, 2, 3 repetitions, 4, 5. Finally, since this takes a little bit of time, we can speed the whole thing up by changing the speed value to a higher number. And when we run it the last time, it'll run a lot faster. 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, so that shows you this iPod Touch application. But you don't really need this iPod Touch application because all it's really sending is tones, which means that any application that sends data tones, touch tones, will control the Arduino. And this is a iPod Touch, so it doesn't have a phone application, but I can use the Skype application, which also sends touch tones, to control this Arduino and to control this motor. So to run the job we just ran from that custom application, all we have to do is hit #0#, and there it goes again. We can make it to fewer repetitions by doing *0, *3, **. And now when we run it again, it will run 3 times instead of 5. And finally, I'm going to slow it down again by changing the speed setting to a slower value. So the last time that I send it, it will turn more slowly again. 3 times. So the way that it works is simply by sending tones. And while I've been using applications on the iPod Touch, you don't really need to use an iPod Touch or an iPhone or any electronic application. You can actually use anything that creates touch tones, which means you can use an old phone handset, which I'm going to plug into the Arduino, and use the phone handset to control the stepper motor just as I controlled it through the applications. So to run the motor that's using the job that's stored in there, I hit #0#, runs 3 times. We can speed it up by hitting #2700 and run it again. It's running fast again. And finally, I'll make it do more repetitions. Instead of 3 times, it's now going 5 times. All right, let me slow it down. Final demonstration with the phone here. And we'll run it one last time. It's doing 3 revolutions, 5 times. Now, there are some advantages to using the iPod Touch application. Anything that makes tones can send instructions to the Arduino, but the tones that come back from the Arduino need to be interpreted by a custom application. So I can run this program again, but I can listen to the tones sent back from the Arduino, and I can use that to display information in this application. So I'm going to run the program again, but this time I'm going to receive back information that gives me the number of rotations that the motor has made. So when I run a program this time, after each rotation, the Arduino comes back and reports how many repetitions that it's made. So I can still change that. I can say I want to make 3. I can send 3. And when it runs again, you'll see it goes 1, 2, 3. Now, I've sent back the number of rotations that the motor has made, but depending on the application, depending on your requirements, you could send other information back from the Arduino.